unless I see the scars of the nails in his hands and put my finger on those scars and my hand in his side, I will not believe.
Thought that the world has kind of lost its way. Crazy as it seems, yeah, I know it's gonna be okay. Ooh, yeah. It doesn't scare me, it's temporary. There's something better we got forever.
Glory to God in the highest. He is risen, just like he said. Not only did he rise, but he continues to transform the lives of those that he met after the resurrection, the power in the risen Christ. And today, we reflect on the significance of one. The significance of one. Christ came back to a certain group for the sake of one. We'll take our reading today from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 20, verse 26. Scripture says, and after 8 days, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Then Jesus came, the doors having been shut, and stood in their midst, and he said, peace to you. Shalom, Irene, to you. Let us pray. Gracious Father in heaven, we are thankful for granting to us an opportunity to ponder and reflect upon your word. So come speak to us, for we desire to hear from you. We indeed want to have interaction with the risen Christ. This is indeed our prayer of faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Christ has risen. He has appeared to his disciples, showed them his hands and his side, but Thomas was not with them. So he says, folks, let me tell you, until I see and poke a finger, until I see and put in my hand, I cannot believe it. I need to see it with my own two eyes. Christ came back to the same gathering in the same manner, only this time that Thomas was with them. The number 8 is significant. It marks a new beginning, the beginning of a new week, the beginning of a new era, the beginning of a new relationship. On the 8th day, Christ appeared. The disciples were behind locked doors. The doors were shut. They were gathered in one room. And despite the doors being shut, Christ appeared in their midst. This is exciting for me. When I ponder on how the nations have locked themselves up, places of worship are forbidden, yet in the midst of this lockdown, the church continues to grow. Because wherever the few are gathered, Christ appears in their midst despite the shut doors. It is exciting that despite the shutdown, despite the lockdown, despite the curfews, no worship services, Christ still appears to us, to speak to us, to encourage us, to empower us. He came back because one was missing, and he wanted to empower that one so that he could be in tandem with the rest. Here in Kenya, Constitution is clear. One is significant because for you to win an election as president, it must be 50% plus one, not two, just one. 50% plus one, you're in business. So one is significant in other areas, but it's also insignificant in others. What is the value of one? What can one shilling, 1 cent, $1, 1 pence. What can it buy? 1 Deutschmark. What can it buy? So sometimes one is not significant. But in the kingdom of God, one is significant. That Christ came back so that Thomas could see, so that Thomas could believe, so that Thomas could tell the story. It might appear like you're locked away, tucked away, forgotten. It might appear like you are not significant, but Christ says to us this morning, He came back from the dead just for you. The value of one, the significance of one. Christ came back for you. He came back for your business. He came back for your family. He came back for your workplace. He came back for your mission in life. He came back because you are significant. And thirdly, His first statement to them is, "Peace be upon you. Shalom." In Hebrew, Irene. In Greek, the significance of the greeting is not just the absence of turmoil. It is the wealth and abundance of the presence of God in one's life. So He came back that your life would be full. Your life, my life, our lives. But the significance is in the one. The power is in the one. The importance is in the one. So you may be one. You're important. He came back just for you. This resurrected Christ speaks God's presence into your business. He speaks God's presence into your hurting life. He speaks God's presence into your grief. He speaks God's presence in its totality upon you. He came back just for one. Let us pray. Gracious Father in heaven, you are thankful for reminding us that you came back just for us. Insignificant as we might appear, you came that we might have life in its abundance. You came just for us to empower us. You came to give us new life. So bless us and be together with us. And this is indeed our prayer of faith in Jesus' name. Amen. And now, I commend you into the hands of the living God, who alone is able to keep you and to sustain you, who alone rose from the dead and came back for you as one, who alone speaks life and life in its abundance upon your life. May this blessing be yours and the ones you love, both now and forevermore. Amen. He came back for one, He came back for you. Help is on the way, round in the